the goal here is to rid the lake of common carp, and they're an invasive species, a naturalized species that's common throughout Wisconsin, but they're especially a problem in shallow lake systems like we have in Indian Lake. And it's because their foraging behavior roots around in the bottom sediments, disturbing plant communities, and also resuspending sediments. And what that does is clouds the water, allows phosphorus to be resuspended and taken up by blue-green algae especially. So when you have carp, they destroy the plant community, also make the water very cloudy, and also has blue-green algae impact. So this lake was basically a blue-green algae outbreak all summer long.
This is one of Dane County's most popular parks. In fact, it was a top 10 park back in the early 2000s by Wisconsin Trails magazine. We have a large dog area, exercise area off leash. We've just completed a new shelter and restroom facility along with some playground amenities. So we get a lot of activity out here in Northwest Dane County, and it's very important that we try to get the lake itself, Indian Lake, back as the centerpiece of this very popular park. Our expectations are we should be able to flip this lake and hopefully it sustains itself for a long time.
So there's a few moving parts to the project. You've probably seen photos or a video of the pump system that's going to draw down the lake, concentrate the fish in this main pool of the lake. And we're gonna treat it with an aerial application using a helicopter pilot with rotenone. Rotenone is the product that we're using. It's a naturally occurring compound in the bean family. It only affects aquatic organisms with gill. In 48 to 72 hours, we expect to have the fish population killed off here, and they'll float to the surface and naturally decompose. They'll be at the surface for a couple days, and then they'll sink to the bottom, and those nutrients will be recycled in the system.
With the removal of the carp, we'll return to a clear water phase and hopefully lessen the likelihood of any blue-green algae blooms, which are problematic because they can be toxic, especially to dogs. And this is a popular area for dog owners to come bring their animals to take a swim or a run along the creek and so on and so forth. So, and then the other main objective is to kind of somewhat return this to a family fishery. So the idea of stocking the bass and bluegill and probably a few catfish will allow mom and dad and grandpa to take the kids down here and really enjoy a couple hours of fishing. So that's what our ultimate